Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to talk about why your waveform update rate is like playing the lottery. So I'm doing this video because in a previous episode, I was asked to cover some basic oscilloscope specs. Now, waveform update rate is a crucial spec that you have to understand on your scope, and essentially, it describes how fast your scope is able to acquire and display signals. Now, the waveform update rate spec on your oscilloscope is much like having tickets to the lottery. The more tickets you have, or the faster your waveform update rate, the more likely you are to win the lottery. And in electrical engineering, winning the lottery is being able to see and identify glitches in your signal, because that's what helps you get your job done faster. Now, the reason I say that is because every oscilloscope on the planet has some dead time. After it triggers and acquires data, and while it's processing and trying to display it, it's gonna not be able to see what's going on in your system because it's doing other things. So let's look at an example. This is a 1 megahertz waveform, and I know that once per second, there's gonna be a glitch. So essentially, this glitch is a 1 in a million glitch, and I have this other scope hooked up using the hardware counter to the trigger out in the back, and that's plugged into channel 1, and we can actually see the waveform update rate of my scope. And the frequency of my trigger output on my scope is 950 kilohertz. So I'm getting 950,000 triggers per second. And that's why I'm seeing this glitch approximately once per second, because the odds are basically 1 that I'm gonna see that glitch. Now, as an engineer, you wanna be able to see this glitch so you know that there's something wrong on your system, because a glitch like this could easily cause failures. If this glitch is happening once per second and once every million waveforms, I'm able to see it once per second because I have 1 million waveforms per second on this scope. But if my scope was maybe 100 waveforms per second, how long is it gonna take you to see that signal? I have to do the math. Okay, there's a million edges that you're gonna have to go through to find this glitch. You're gonna have to go through it 100 waveforms at a time in a second, and then you divide that by 60 seconds in a minute, divided by 60 minutes in an hour. It's gonna take you 2.8 hours to see that glitch, and that's why I talk about waveform update rate like it's winning the lottery, because if you have a slow waveform update rate, you're not gonna win and see that glitch. So I was editing and I realized I couldn't get everything into one episode that I wanted to cover, so I made a bonus episode. It also posted today. It covers what affects your update rate and how do you measure the update rate on your oscilloscope. Thanks for watching. Hit the subscribe button and I will see you next week.